This is the free version of DaVinci Resolve on Linux. OpenSUSE Linux, to be exact. It kinda works. The video I have loaded, which is a recording of some Witcher 3 gameplay with my A770, and, well, the playback is, well... Now, before you start thinking this is just another case of a botched Nvidia driver install, let me clear something up. You see, I'm not running this with an Nvidia GPU. I'm running DaVinci Resolve on Linux with my Intel Arc A770. There are some caveats. First off, the free version of DaVinci Resolve on Linux has some general codec limitations, and Arc isn't special. You can't just use any codec you want with the free version, especially if it involves proprietary licensing. For example, I recorded this video using AAC as the audio codec, and the free version of Resolve doesn't support AAC on Linux, because AAC doesn't have an open or free license. So I wanted to see if I could use another audio codec. I could have used Wave, but then I thought, what about FLAC? And yes, FLAC works fine, too. Now, here's a catch that's kind of the result of the previous catch. On Windows, if you're using Intel Arc, you can render an AV1, but on Linux, not yet. The feature isn't available at the moment, but if you need AV1 rendering for your workflow, you can always convert your footage using tools like Handbrake or FFmpeg, and, well, you'll have AV1 encode-decode support on your Arc card, or Meteor Lunar Arrow Lake CPU or SoC. Are we calling them SoCs yet? The last and most obvious issue is timeline playback. It's pretty rough. You can barely see what's going on. But here's the upside. Despite these playback issues, it renders. Yes, we've got a fully rendered video at the end. In the free version of DaVinci Resolve, this card is surprisingly close to achieving Nvidia-level functionality on Linux. Until recently, DaVinci Resolve has only really been usable on Linux with an Nvidia GPU. Sure, you could use AMD GPUs, but that required using Rockham, and navigating that setup is not for the faint of heart. Plus, Rockham doesn't support all AMD cards. From what I understand, for instance, you can't run Rockham on a 6700 XT, but if I'm getting that wrong, feel free to tell me in the comments. With Intel Arc, all I had to do was install the card, boot up my system, assuming you're running a recent kernel, and install a few packages from my distro's repositories. If you want to know which packages, well, I have a video about that. Strangely enough, Nvidia is just now really getting serious about open drivers on Linux, and AMD has gotten marginally more serious about GPU compute only after Intel Arc has shown up on the scene. But I'm just saying. I think there's a lot of people on the fence about using Linux as their primary environment, especially when it comes to creative work like video editing. Having DaVinci Resolve on Linux, with the ability to use a GPU other than Nvidia for hardware-accelerated video editing, is a big deal. And yes, in an ideal world, I'd be ecstatic if open-source software like Kden Live could reach this level. But as is often the case with free software, progress takes time. Right now, and hopefully in the near future, the combination of affordability and improving Linux compatibility gives Intel a real chance to capture market share, especially among users looking for high-performance setups without paying Nvidia's premium prices. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. If this video was helpful, please like and consider subscribing. Thanks for watching. Take care.